Okay, so today is Thursday. I actually picked up a 4-hour shift today. Again, wanting extra money, so I'm working from 7 to 11. I'm late, as always. So I'll take you along on a quick little shift. Again, I pick up whenever I want because I am a PRN nurse, so yeah. Here we go, another day. Got what to do. Okay, so because my shift is kind of so short, I'm only working from 7 to 11, I was placed to sit one-on-one with a patient who requires a continuous one-on-one sitter. So just a few pointers when you are sitting one-on-one with a patient who requires a continuous one-on-one sitter, just make sure you're documenting everything that needs to be documented. Even if you feel like you're over-documenting, you can never document too much. Just make sure you're documenting everything that needs to be documented. And also make sure you're staying safe because there are patients who can be combative. Okay, so on this particular night, this patient required canvas restraints because of potential harm that could be done to himself or myself. Just make sure that when you have an order for a canvas restraints in your flow sheets that you're documenting specifically the patient's behavior that indicates a continued need for the restraints, the patient's mental status, including the orientation, the number and type of restraints used and where they're actually placed, the conditions of extremities, including circulation and sensation. And just also make sure that you can actually place two fingers between yourself and the patient's wrist. Okay, I know y'all probably thinking like, what are you doing? Why are you documenting your hours? So our timekeeping machine is Chronos, and it has been down for like a month. And so we have to track our hours. And y'all, I am so upset because this last pay period, I forgot to track. I work like a series amount of overtime and forgot to write it down. So I missed that on my paycheck and I'm really upset. Okay, so I wanted to share with you a little tip that I was shown by another nurse in order to warm the solution for peritoneal dialysis. If you didn't know, peritoneal dialysis is a way to remove waste products from your blood when your kidneys can't adequately do the job any longer. Specifically, it's for people who are already in the stage of end-stage renal disease. This procedure filters your blood in a different way than does the more common blood filtering procedure called hemodialysis. In doing peritoneal dialysis, a cleansing fluid flows through a tube into part of your abdomen. The lining of your abdomen, called the peritoneum, acts as a filter and removes waste products from your blood. After a set period of time, the fluid with the filtered waste products flows out of your abdomen and is discarded. Okay, so in order to warm the solution for a patient with peritoneal dialysis, as you can see in this video, there is a warmer that is used in order to warm the bags. And you're supposed to basically place the solution bag inside of the this paper part of the warmer, and it's supposed to warm it. It does take a series of time, so if the wrong bag is inside, you are kind of out of luck. So alternative way to warm the bag is just basically to give the solution a hot water bath. And so I got a simple basin and I just filled it up with hot water, as you can see. And then basically I do that a series of times until the bag is at a good temperature in order to be put through the patient's peritoneal cavity. Thank you.